Hey everyone, it's Taylor. While most people change jobs several times during their lives, some know at a young age the career they want for a lifetime. Today, you'll hear from one of those individuals. She's a nurse practitioner, and after meeting her and learning about her job, you might be interested in joining the medical field too.
I knew pretty early on that I wanted to work in healthcare. I am fascinated with the way that our bodies work, and I knew that I wanted some sort of career that I was able to help people and really see that I was making a difference.
Emily began her career as a registered nurse. After graduating college with a bachelor's degree, she worked as an RN for several years before deciding she wanted to take it to the next level.
One of the things that really attracted to me to the role of a nurse practitioner was that you care for your patients over a longer period of time versus as a registered nurse, you maybe see them in the hospital just for kind of episodic visits. And so I really wanted to have a longer relationship with my patients.
Building those relationships is just one characteristic that Emily thinks is vital to being successful as a nurse.
Being compassionate is required, you know, for being a nurse and a nurse practitioner. And so first, I would start with that. Secondly, you have to be hardworking. And so not only to get through school, there's a lot of studying that's involved. And then afterwards, you know, we work hard. And so sometimes, depending on what setting you're in, your job can be physically demanding, and sometimes it's more emotionally demanding. So you have to be compassionate. You have to be a hard worker. You also have to have just like a good sense of humor.
Wait, a sense of humor for nursing?
Sometimes you're dealing with really difficult patients, really difficult situations. And so you need to have a good sense of humor.
Okay, so let's review quickly. Emily says nurses should be compassionate, willing to handle hard work, and have a sense of humor. But one trait is of the utmost importance.
You have to like people. And so it would be really difficult to do your job if you didn't like people.
Emily's compassion and care for others is evident. She could have chosen to practice in a setting where she earns more money. Instead,
and I work at a clinic called a community clinic, and we serve all kinds of patients, but especially serve patients who do not have insurance or are kind of, we would consider them underinsured.
At the clinic, Emily specializes in women's health. Specifically, she provides prenatal care and gynecological services.
Quickly, I knew that I loved women's health. I loved labor and delivery and postpartum and taking care of newborn babies. And so those were the jobs that I looked for after I graduated.
To become a nurse practitioner, one must first complete a bachelor's degree. From there, one can obtain either a master's degree or a doctorate. Earning an advanced degree may seem daunting to some, but it will likely be well worth the investment. As of May 2020, the U.S. Bureau of Labor shows that nurse practitioners earned an annual median income of nearly $120,000, almost triple the median national income, and the demand continues to grow.
There is a primary care provider shortage in our nation, and many physicians prefer to choose specialties that are more lucrative. And so many of them will not go into family practice or primary care. And that's a great place for nurse practitioners and physicians assistants because we can provide that care.
While healthcare workers are in demand for most positions, there is a particular need for individuals like Emily.
I'm a nurse practitioner, and nurse practitioners, the job market for that is increasing as well.
Very much so. As of 2019, there were 263,400 men and women across the United States who worked as nurse practitioners. It's estimated that the nation will need another 120,000 by 2029. Opportunities for nurse practitioners are projected to grow by 45% through 2029, more than 10 times the average for all occupations.
One of the great things about nursing, too, is that you can work in all the different areas. And so if you work in women's health and then you get tired of that, you can take your skill set and apply it to critical care or a different field and become as well-rounded as you would like to be.
Emily added that students interested in a career as a nurse practitioner or another job in healthcare can begin exploring the field now.
In high school, I took classes like anatomy and physiology, and that was definitely helpful to get some exposure to terminology that we use in the medical field. I use that all of the time.
There are options other than coursework too. For example,
I also spent a lot of time volunteering and just helping people in my community. And so I think that's something that you could do right now.
One thing about healthcare is that you will probably know in your first class whether it's right for you.
Something that's great too about nursing is that pretty quickly you know if you like it or you don't. And so you are in the hospital setting or taking care of patients. And so it's very easy to know if this is something that you would like.
And as Emily mentioned earlier, you will also get a chance to be in different settings while receiving that training. The options for nurses are plentiful.
You're exposed to lots of different areas, you know, whenever you go through nursing school, whether that's labor and delivery or critical care or medical surgical, lots of different areas. So you can kind of get an idea of what you like the best.
If you decide a career as a nurse is for you, perhaps you will follow Emily's lead to become a nurse practitioner. But make no mistake, the job is very different from nursing.
That is a role change from being a registered nurse where you're taught to assess. And then whenever you're a nurse practitioner, you're actually diagnosing and treating patients. You're sending in medications, you're ordering labs.
The most drastic change is the increased responsibility.
It's a bit of a transition, you know, to go from someone who's like receiving orders to somebody who's giving them.
Whether an individual works as a nurse his or her entire career or mimics Emily's choice to become a nurse practitioner, she said that you will have countless opportunities.
There is almost always a nursing shortage, but especially now, like during the pandemic. And so job security is something that I can't imagine will ever be an issue, you know, for a nurse.
Of course, Emily never worried much about such things. She always knew what she wanted to do.
When I was little, I pretty quickly knew that I wanted to be involved in the medical profession in somehow.
Unlike Emily, most young people don't know what they want to do for a living as an adult. In fact, you may be thinking right now,
oh man, this isn't for me.
Or maybe you're thinking you'd absolutely love it.
Nursing, you know pretty quickly.
But if you are compassionate, willing to work hard, have a sense of humor, and enjoy building relationships with people, then you may want to do more research or take an introductory nursing course and perhaps give a big thank you to Emily for sharing so much about her career. Hey, hey.